students, so I welcome you all again to the online class of physical education, class 12. So today I have come with the second part of chapter 4, that is physical education and sports for children with special needs. As you can see, students, in the board, so today first of all we are going to discuss about various organizations that promote adaptive physical education, or various organizations that promote games and sports for children with special needs. Okay, so in the process we are going to discuss the first one. The first organization is Special Olympic Bharat, as you can see, students, on the top. So this is one type of organization that promotes the adaptive physical educations. So basically, in Special Olympic Bharat, the children with intellectual disabilities, they participate. I repeat, the children with intellectual disabilities, they participate in Special Olympic Bharat. So let us understand a few things. At first, this organization prepares the progress with physical and mental disability. As I told you, that the intellectual disabled candidate participates in Special Olympic Bharat. So this organization prepares the progress with physical and mental disability for Special Olympic. Next is, at national level they are trained. So the individuals with intellectual disabilities, they are trained at national level to participate in 24 single and team games by Sports Authority of India. Moving to next, this organization was established in 2001 as per the Act of 1982. As you see, students, the another type of organization that promotes adaptive physical education is Paralympics. We also call it as Paralympics. Here, basically the children with physical disability, those who are having physical disability, that means they don't have legs properly, they don't have one hand. So those individuals, when they participate in Olympics, it is known as Paralympics. So let's see what is Paralympic is. This is similar to Olympic Games, students. This is similar to Olympic Games for disabled sportspersons. As I told you, the children with special needs, they also have the desire to participate. Some of them are having lot of potentiality. So to give those individuals a platform, adaptive physical education come into existence. Now, for them, sports events are also being conducted. Now, when we talk of Paralympics, these are very much similar to Olympic Games. And as we are all well aware that Olympic Games are the highest platform in games and sports. So, moving to next, the first time it was organized in Rome in 1960. So first time the Paralympic game was organized in Rome in 1960. Students, you please keep these things in mind, because objective type questions can be asked from these topics, that when the first Paralympic game was organized, in which country it was organized. So these are all objective type questions can be asked from the topic. Next, students, the headquarters of International Para Olympic is situated in Bonn, that is located in Germany. The International Para Olympic is responsible for organizing Summer and Winter Olympic Games. So it is very much similar to Olympic Games, as in Olympic Games also Winter and Summer Olympic Games are hosted. So similarly for para athletes also, Summer and Winter Para Olympic Games are conducted. Now you see, Para Olympic, so these are type of Olympic Games which are running parallel, which are running parallel to the normal Olympic Games. Okay, next, at present it comprises of 176 National Paralympic Committee. So at present there are 176 National Paralympic Committees, that means 176 nations are registered, 176 nations are the member country of International Paralympic Committee, or we call it Paralympic Games. So moving ahead, students, next is Deaflympic. This is the third organization that helps in the organizing of games and sports events for children with special needs. So from the name itself we can analyze that Deaflympics, here in these sort of sporting event, the individuals with hearing impairment, the individuals who cannot hear properly, they only take part in Deaflympics. So let's see, the Deaflympics are games for deaf athletes. So moving ahead, its earlier name was International Games for the Deaf. So earlier it was known as International Games for the Deaf. Next, these games are organized by the International Committee of Sports for the Deaf. That means the committee that looks after the Deaflympics is known as International Committee of Sports for Deaf. Since the first event, and they are sanctioned by International Olympic Committee, so they are approved. These games are approved by International Olympic Committee. So moving ahead, students, Deaflympics were held first time in Paris in 1924. That means the first Deaflympics were held in Paris in the year 1924. It was the first ever international sporting events for athletes with disability. The Deaflympics Winter Games started in the year 1949. Then it was gathering of 148 athletes. So when for the first time the Winter Deaflympics take place, only 148 athletes take part. Now these games are grown into a global movement. So from 148 to most of the nation today are registered under Deaflympics. To qualify for the games, athletes must have hearing loss. So the eligibility criteria to participate in Deaflympic is, to qualify in these games, athletes must have a hearing loss. A hearing loss, that means at least of 55 decibel in their better ear. Okay. Next, students, next we move on to the another topic, that is concept of inclusion. Now with the image I have tried to make you understand. Just see, so many hands are raising up. assume your classroom situation. When a teacher asks, when a teacher puts up a question, there are many students raising their hand to answer the question of the teacher. So, here the concept of inclusion means including the disabled child with a normal child. That means the disabled child are also given an opportunity to mingle with other general individuals. So that is what I have tried to make you understand with the image, with lot of hands with different colors. Because students, the children with special needs also have the desire, again and again I am telling you this line, and desires need to be respected, otherwise the child will be seriously depressed. He will think that he is not having any value in the society. So, to just protect this child, to save this child, to develop the self-confidence level of children with special needs, government has come up with inclusion program. So let's see what inclusion mean. So in the next slide, students, as you can see, inclusion is a social concept which basically means to include everyone as normal member of society by mutual cooperation. That means everyone in the society as a normal member of the society, it is being treated. The program of inclusion treats everyone, every individual as a normal member of the society. The next one is, the concept is often confused. Now, the concept of inclusion is often confused with building a community of certain class. Because students, in inclusive education program, basically the children with special needs are included. As I told you, they are included with other normal individuals. So, a wrong mind, a misconception is developed. That is, building a community of certain class. Certain class is the children with special needs. So it is not like that. It is just to give them a platform where everybody is treated like a normal individuals. So moving ahead, students. Inclusion is not a strategy to help people. It is not a strategy to help people fit into the system. It is not like that there is a system and you just fit it like gadgets. So instead of that, the structures which exist in our societies, it is about transforming those systems. Means remodifying the structures which are prevailing in our society. Because by remodifying the existing structures can help the children with special needs a lot. So moving ahead, in the next slide, students, we will be understanding about the various needs of inclusion. That is, inclusion in physical education helps the students with disabilities to increase their social skills and improvise them. So, the inclusion in physical education helps. How it helps? The child It helps the child in developing the social skills and improvise them. Improvise them means they modify them. They have their own skills. The next one is, a child feels that he or she also belongs to the entire group of class. So a feeling of belongings is developed. As I told you earlier, if they are not given respect, if they are not being included with other children, other normal children, they will feel alone, they will feel aloof. So that is why, to keeping that in mind, the inclusive program helps the children to belong to the entire group of class. They also feel that they are given importance, and that helps them to develop their self-confidence also. Next one is, inclusion helps a child to increase his or her motor skills and lead a normal life. So inclusion program also helps the child to develop his motor skills. Now when we talk of motor skills means all those skills which a child learns after taking birth till death. That includes walking, running, jumping, throwing, catching, etc., etc. Motor skills plays the base creation of every individual, and they also help to lead them, to lead the children in normal life. So moving ahead, students, in the next slide we will be understanding about how to implement. We have understood the need. Now the thing comes, how to implement the inclusive education program. So first of all, parents, students and teachers all need to work together towards implementation of inclusion program. So the three stakeholders, they are the parents, the students as well as the teachers. All three of them need to have coordination when the inclusive education program needs to be implemented. Next is, one should have knowledge of inclusive practices. So one must have the knowledge of inclusive practices and strategies. With the knowledge of teachers can manage classrooms that encourage learning. So with the knowledge of inclusive practices and strategies, it helps the teachers can manage classrooms that encourage learning and discovery among all students regardless of physical abilities. In inclusive education program, there will be some normal individuals, those who are having more potentiality. Also, there are few individuals who are lagging in potentiality level because somewhere they are suffering from any disability or disorder. So that means, students, with the help of knowledge of inclusive practices and strategies, it helps the teachers. It helps the teacher to have better learning in inclusive education classroom. Moving ahead, inclusion also requires specially trained staff. That means the staff members need to be trained specially for inclusive education classrooms. Since classroom teachers need training and ongoing support to effectively teach many types of learners, they must meet regularly with inclusive specialists. So, the teachers who are who are responsible for inclusive education classrooms, they need to always be in touch with inclusion specialist. Because when they are in touch with inclusion specialist, they come to gain more and more knowledge. Whenever they are having any problem with discussion with the specialist, the inclusion specialist, their knowledge is being updated. So moving next, school principals and all teachers must cooperate and share the message that all staff members, it should not be the duty of only specialized teachers but every teacher. So this is the message, student. The message is, it is not only the duty of specialized teacher. Specialized teacher means the teacher who is present or who is handling the special needed children, but it is the duty of all the teachers who are managing the children with special needs. Okay, so this is all about the inclusive education program, students. I hope you have understood the concept of inclusion as well as the need of inclusion and its various implementation. So if you have any problem, students, if you have any doubt, you can personally approach me. I will feel very happy to help you in clearing your doubts. So thank you, all of you, students.